They say I'm the plug, I don't talk it out. Yo, welcome everyone to a new video. So today we're talking about KB's Today We Rebel album cover. D-Raj has a new project out and I actually got sent it early, so I'll go over that a little bit. And also Ruslan's got a weekly out, if you guys didn't know. I'll go over that a bit later on. And just to address something real quick, there was the Aha Gazelle kind of drama. If you guys followed it, I mean, that's cool. If you didn't, that's alright. What I have to say on that, I was thinking about making a video on it, but I don't want any more drama. It's kind of petty, and I know it'll get views, and there's a lot I could say on that. There was some tweets that the manager put out, and yeah, I just don't want to talk about it, so I hope you guys understand that. I want to try and keep it as positive as we can here, and you know, I know for me, and I know some of you guys as well, feeling kind of jaded from all the drama that we've had recently, and also seeing the same names pop up in your subscription feed every day. So I wanted to talk about D-Raj and Ruslan in this video as well. Very interesting stuff, so stay to the end to listen to that. But with KB, so he put out on Instagram about 9 pictures all making up his album cover, and I was blown away by this, man. I think it's really cool. There's a lot of messages like KB sitting down on a throne with a picture of Jesus behind him with a halo around his head, and then it looks like something draped over his knees, which is like the Tomorrow We Live logo, and then like a whole lot of symbols and stuff as well. It's very interesting. There's a ton to look into it. I probably won't look into it that much, honestly, but it looks so sick. Really, really like it. I think Alex Medina had something to do with the design of it, or like the idea of it, so shout out to him for that. This blew me away, man. I was not expecting something like this. I'm sure there's a lot more meaning to it than I'm saying right now, but it's really sick. I can't wait. It looks like he's announced that it's October 20th or whatever it is, but we still don't have the track list, which is another interesting thing. I hope it's like 14 tracks, not 12 tracks, because I mean, we pretty much know it's 12 tracks because of the tweet that Natalie Lauren put out, but we can still hope. The track list still isn't up yet, so we don't know if it's 12 tracks. But anyway, into the D-Raj stuff. So I was lucky enough, Reflection Music Group or RMG actually sent me D-Raj's Goodish early. So, I mean, shout out to RMG, man. I really appreciate it. The fact that I get to listen to songs and projects early. I mean, I've gotten to listen to the Ty Brazzle project early, the one that just went. I mean, this project, Surf Gang let me hear this song a few days early as well. So, super awesome. Thank you guys so much. Really, really like this project, especially because I have an EDM background. For you guys who don't, you might not like it as much, but it's super refreshing, especially when I'm listening to Christian hip hop all day, because it's pretty much my job now at the moment. And I mean, like with doing YouTube, I'm always listening to different Christian hip hop, whether it's trying to find new artists or whatever, and it's super refreshing. There's only really one like rap song or rap hip hop song. The other ones are kind of more geared towards, I would say, mainstream Christian or just pop in general, and I actually really, really like those songs. But the rap song has a feature with Chris Batson. I believe that's how you say his name. He has a lot of features with Social Club. If you guys are familiar with Social Club and their music, he has like 2 features at least on almost every project they put out. And Fern of Social Club, I was so excited when I saw that. I'm gonna be honest, I haven't really followed D-Raj that much, but dude, I'm a massive fan of 68 and Douglas, the EP that Firm put out, and also Marty's individual EP as well. Really would love to see 2 new projects from Marty and Firm, like solo ones as well. But anyway, dude, this track goes so hard. I mean, D-Raj does good on it. Chris Batson has awesome chorus, and Firm like snaps on this. The flow with his beat, it's so Firm as well. So yeah, man, if there's one track that I would tell you guys to go and listen to. If you're not going to buy it, then I'll go and listen to Go Off. But yeah, I mean, if you want something fresh, go and buy this or go and stream it. Really cool project. And it's coming out on Friday, I believe. So, I mean, by the time this video goes out, it'll be out for me. Not you Americans, though. So, anyway, into the Ruslan thing now. I'll be 100% transparent here. So, Ruslan hit me up asking if I would shout out his weekly. And also, we've had, like, a little bit of back and forth. Like, I've commented on his stuff, and then he replied, and then whatever. So, he asked if I could talk about his weekly. I've also talked about Indy Jones and his weeklies, or at one weekly, because one of you guys were egging me on, saying I was sleeping on Ruslan in the past. But anyway, so he asked me, and then I actually watched this dude that really, really good. If I watched this by myself, I probably would have talked about it anyway, so definitely go and check it out. The beat is hard, the lyrics are hard, really, really good. I know I used to have Ruslan on my featured channels, well, I had quite a few. I've kind of just narrowed it down to the people that I'm kind of friends with, or like we both have each other on the featured channels. So anyway, like, I've liked Ruslan's content, and yeah, I mean, go and check out his other stuff as well. But this weekly is really good. Definitely go and check it out. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I know you guys wanted some Aha Gazelle stuff, but I'm sorry. I just really don't want to feed into it. Also, I did a poll. I do polls on Twitter. Follow me at David Livick about what videos you guys want. And the Outcasts of Christian Hip Hop almost got like 50% of the votes, well, as of now. But obviously, this isn't the Outcasts of Christian Hip Hop. That video might take a little bit of time, and also because I have to do research and stuff, but also with the KB album cover, it's kind of timely news to put this out first. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Go follow me on Twitter at David Livick if you support what I'm doing. Patreon, our chat is like really, really awesome. We have really good in-depth discussions about Christian hip hop or just whatever, because we've got like 3 Europeans, 3 Americans, I'm obviously from New Zealand, so it's quite diverse. If you guys want to support, be a part of that chat. $1 a month is the minimum, so it's not that much. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in my next video.